Every time I try to leave, something keeps pulling me back, telling me I need you in my life. Every time I try to go, something keeps pulling me back,
good. It's show me JuztKP and we live in this bit.
What's up?
It's Percolate
3 podcast.
This your girl Hamz.
And we got a special guest in this bit.
You
very
boy
special.
Superstar Guala.
You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna let Hamz introduce. Why you looking at me like that? You go introduce, man. Talking about him all the time.
I don't talk about him all the time. Don't make him smell.
I'll be
like
listening.
That.
I know, right?
I'll be listening.
Either way, this is the one and only and infamous Marquise Boone, a.k.a. Superstar Guala, a.k.a. my boyfriend.
This where you cue the round of applause. And
you know what I'm saying? I ain't that technical. I ain't like Joe Budden. I got the button. I
got
to figure that shit out.
Drop on the KP blast.
You know what I'm saying?
It's been a minute.
Say Happy New Year.
Happy motherfucking New Year.
It's motherfucking 2020, day one, 2020 at
right.
that.
One of 365.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Hold up. It's a leap year, ain't
it? Yep.
366.
You know what I'm saying? 366. Leap year. Niggas here.
Can you believe it?
Can't believe it. Couples here. If I go on a date. Perfect time to get y'all in here,
it's
man.
It's
Oh, y'all going on
like
double dates. Oh, it's a group date. Okay.
It was about 8-9 of us.
Oh, I thought it was just us folks.
No.
See how they do? We hold that information.
No. Right.
I'm glad I got drinks.
We eating though.
Who you eating with?
It's Kay, her fiance, Jamila, and one of Kay's other friends. That's all I can remember right now. And Mason.
That's all you I can know, remember. You all holding on none of them.
Yeah, we really trying to just eat. We trying to throw down.
You know, Boone. You know, you a barber. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There was some shit going on.
Oh, you want to talk about that?
Already, man. Off gate, man.
Off gate.
Hale said she want to talk about it.
All right, so we gonna segue, or you just want me to jump off into it?
Gotta blow that shit. Give an introduction, man. Hamz.
I mean, you just do your thing.
All right, so basically, I'm a barber. I've been a fan of this dude I've been following on the ground for a minute. His name is The Hair Taylor on Instagram, but he pretty much does like total makeovers on clippers as far as customization and calibration and all that stuff. So long story short, basically I sent him my stuff back in October and I haven't got it back yet. So months, like doing DMs and emails and all types of stuff, trying to reach out and getting different answers back. I finally went to Instagram and put a face to the name, as you could say. So I kind of asked my followers to jump out there and tag my name on this page and stuff.
Yeah.
And basically, I just put one post out there. She the one seen the post and started going crazy.
Get this nigga.
I had been waiting for him to give me the green light. We about to spam this motherfucker.
I mean, it's been a minute, wild. Though. And even like after I first had my first concerns about it, she was like, so is you like going to put him on blast or nothing like that? And I just was like, I mean, not really, because I don't want to bring light to the situation, and people be like, "Yeah, right." I'm still gonna fuck with it.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying. So, but at this point, I had seen him, he was going away from Instagram because the last time that I had talked to him, they said he was in the hospital. So he was going away from Instagram. Well, I'm gonna say at least about 6 weeks. He was going away from Instagram, no posts, no nothing. So one day I'm at the shop, I'm working or whatever. Oh, by the way, I had to buy a whole new set of clippers.
That costs a lot of money.
So I'm at the shop and I'm working. I'm on Instagram. And I see him go live. So I hop on this live and I ask him a question. You know what I'm saying?
Like, I hop in that.
Right?
Yo.
Soon I ain't even hear what he was talking about. I type my question quick, fast. Where my stuff at? Live ended. I ain't heard nothing. So I was like, all right, I'm going to DM him every day until I get a response from something. So I was DMing them every day for like 10 days. And it got to the point where I seen the DM. And it, you know how I say seen?
Mm-hmm.
I was tight. When I seen that joke say seen and he didn't respond, I was tight.
He probably opened it on accident. He was like, what? Fuck.
So then that's when I went to my Instagram and asked my followers and the people who support me to, you know what I'm saying, call them out and see what we can type of information we could get. So basically, they sent a long DM and it was saying like
bullshit.
The government seized all the items that we have, da 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 da. If you can give us your information, we can have your stuff to you by Tuesday. And it's Wednesday, goddamn.
Oh, the government? The fuck was that nigga doing?
I don't know.
Okay.
Since the government ain't gonna get involved, I was just like, I might have to get me a lawyer if I want that stuff back. But honestly, I want my stuff and my bread back, so I'll probably have to get a lawyer.
Man, hell yeah.
I need my bread back,
bro. Hell yeah, that's wild.
It wasn't even a lot of bread. It was just the fact that I paid that bread.
It's a lot.
I didn't get my stuff back.
$20 a lot.
And then I had to spend more bread so I could go back to work. Like, I was out of work for a month.
Yeah, that's a good little lawsuit, man.
Yeah, like I was out of work for a month, dog.
Right, pain and suffering, compensation, no income coming in because of his ass.
Yeah.
And I was ready. Soon as he said,
look at the
boy.
Hey, you know that.
Every fucking picture.
Well, you know that meme? Would they be like, when you want to see your food back?
You want to see your food back? Nah, man.
Y'all made one post and she went crazy.
Hell no.
I went crazy. My followers went crazy. Like, everybody was like, you know, he limited his comments. I'm like, DM him, go back to his very first picture on Instagram. I don't care. That's wild. To spam this motherfucker until we get a response.
That nigga said the government.
Yeah. What's crazy is, though, no matter how big or small your following is, the people who fuck with you, if you ask them to do some shit,
They'll fuck with you.
Because we definitely, like I said, it was 10 days after I seen him get back on Instagram. I ain't hear nothing until I went like, hey, y'all go spam his page. Well, till she went like, y'all go spam his page.
Spam.
So I appreciate everybody who might be listening who helped me out. You know what I'm saying? It's job well done. I got a little bit of headway, even though I'm probably going to have to get a lawyer. But, hey, you live and you learn.
Right. And if you guys know some good lawyers out here in the North Carolina area, you can hit us up. Drop it in the comments. Let us know on how we should go about the situation. Because, you know, we don't deal with stuff like that every day. But it just pisses me off because it's this big movement. Support black businesses. It's this big movement. You need to support small businesses. But what really frustrates me, because I work in the servicing business, it's all about providing exceptional service, mm-hmm. is that these businesses do not care about the service part. we are what keep your business going. We're your supporters. If anything, you need to provide communication. You need to be honest. It's all about service. That's how your business is going to thrive. So
that's true.
The next time a motherfucker hit me up about, oh, you're not supporting black businesses, or, oh, you're not supporting small businesses, things like that, I want them to really think about, are you really doing all you can do as an entrepreneur, as an owner, making sure you're providing the best services for the people that are helping your business, that are growing your business. Like, you have the best shit in the world. If your service sucks, people are not going to buy from you.
Hey, that's facts. Hey, that's how old dude grew Amazon, though. He was like, he put customer service number one.
Yes.
Like, that's why no matter what's wrong with your shit at Amazon, you can turn that shit back anytime.
Amazon customer service is
A1, goddamn. That shit made me not want to fuck with anybody else.
Right. And I think people forget that start their business.
They don't think about customer service.
They don't think about that.
They don't think about that. Nah.
They don't think about that. So, yeah, I was ticked off.
Speaking of Amazon, do you know Amazon that got to the point where they got this shit called Amazon Wardrobe?
Hey, tell me why. That's why I got my Gino outfit. You see that shit?
What is Amazon Wardrobe?
That shit for free, nigga.
Listen, Amazon Wardrobe. How they got Amazon Prime, right?
Yeah.
And it'll tell you if it's eligible for Prime before you start clicking on stuff.
Yeah.
So if you looking for clothes, they got this junk called Amazon Wardrobe. And you can order clothes that's approved on Amazon Wardrobe. And I think you get to keep them for like, what, seven days?
7 days, yeah.
And if you, anything that you don't want from what you order, you can send
that shit back.
You won't get charged for it. But they can charge you for the stuff that you keep.
And I'm talking about, I had them Lacoste shades. They have a nice shit on there too, man.
They do be having some shit on there.
I'm like, whoa, these $300 shades.
That's what I'm saying.
Y'all just giving them bitches like that? I was a scamming nigga, boy. I'd be scamming like a motherfucker, but I ain't a scammer though.
Hey, that's how I got my G-Hole.
Giving them niggas fake credit cards and shit.
That's lit.
Yeah, let me get them right there, man.
That's lit.
That's wild, man.
Amazon got it, man, with the music, the TV, the wardrobe. Amazon lit.
Amazon got them trucks.
Yeah.
Them trucks, boy. Nigga, I bought some Christmas shit. It was like 2 days before Christmas, boy. I got no truck pull up, blasting Future. Nigga, I hop out. Like, yo, you go, bro. I was like, what? Y'all niggas doing
they
have your
folks
own
working
shit
around the clock.
Them niggas doing their own shit. Like, you can start your own business. Like, you can start like a Amazon truck business.
Really?
Mm-hmm. If you got like 10,000 down, if you put 10,000 down, I don't know what the demand like in Greensboro, but if you put 10,000 down, like, they'll provide. That's how they popping up with all these trucks. Because it's individual people, like, you know what I'm saying?
And
put their money down.
And them drive fast as hell. They will pull out in front of your ass.
Good ass joint. Set your own schedule, you know what I'm saying?
The Sprinter joint?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, Amazon Sprinters. So them, like, independent people, but they work for Amazon.
Wow.
That's crazy, because they come in with
Uber.
A contract then.
Yeah.
They probably can get another contract off the side.
That shit like Uber.
Uber is paying for people to get transportation fleets, like fleets of cars and stuff, though.
That is true. That's lit.
And then Uber got Sprinters, too. What? Uber's got helicopters.
I seen that shit.
Uber got helicopters, yo.
What the hell somebody Uber got, need with a helicopter?
And you got, and what? The junk's so slick, bro. When you book a helicopter, they call an Uber car to pick you up and take you to the helipad. Then it's lift off.
And they have a driver too?
Yeah.
That shit wild.
I heard about this on the Breakfast Club that DJ Envy tried.
That's wild.
That's wild.
Crazy.
I seen it on Twitter. It was like in New York or some shit. And she was like, the helicopter was cheaper than getting the ride. It was like a busy ass day or some shit. But like the regular ride was like $200.
No, it had to be like a big Uber or something.
Baby.
That had to have been the Uber, what is it? Uber Select or some shit?
Uber XL.
Uber Black.
With the luxury car. It had to have been that, boy.
That's 200. Crazy.
What, they was going to New Jersey?
Right.
What the hell?
That's funny as hell.
All right, so boom, this for you, man. I've been reading, Hamz, you probably have some input too. But I've been reading Kevin Hart book, the one came out like two years ago, the old shit. And he was talking about how like one of the shit, like he got one of the people that rolled in his crew, like the paper bomb, what is it, the paper cup boys?
Plastic cup boys,
I said paper.
Same thing.
One of them is his barber. And you know what I'm saying? He talked about how he met him in LA And so, like, when he was young, like, you know, his mama would always cut his hair, like, put the bowl on his head and cut that shit around. Mm-hmm. She wouldn't never pay for him getting no haircut. So when he got money, like, that's, like, something he prioritized. And so he was like, yeah, when I made it, I told my barber, I was like, yeah, man, come be a part of the tour or whatever. But he was talking about just, like, crazy shit that used to happen in the barbershop. And, you know, the niggas that go in the barbershop, you know, that's, like, the barbershop and it's, like, the locker room. You know, it's just like niggas talk.
The two,
like,
spaces where niggas
where
talk.
Niggas can,
like,
talk and be, you know what I'm saying? And let shit go. And my question for you, since you a barber, you know what I'm saying? What's the craziest shit you done seen in a barbershop?
Or story you done heard in a barbershop?
Oh, I done
or
the heard, craziest shit somebody heard. I done heard mad stories. I done heard stories of the feds running in and shutting everything down. Because I know it was this barbershop. I ain't gonna let y'all know where it was at, but everybody in there got brought up on RICO charge, and this was probably like 16 months ago. Like the feds,
oh, this is recent.
Yeah, this feds ran up in the barbershop during business hours, took everybody out that joint handcuffed. I was like, yo, that's crazy.
Imagine
but,
your haircut not done.
Imagine.
You get and everybody
you get everybody
going,
you still sitting there with your hair half done.
And the cake and everything. Or what if you was getting your hair washed or something like that? You
right.
Just out here
right.
Wet.
Shampoo
wet head. No, wet right. Head. No edge up. Damn.
Yo.
But what else? What I think the funniest thing in the barbershop is when women come in there and they think their opinion matters.
Bro, it doesn't matter. It don't, bro.
Listen, when women come in there and they think their opinion matters, it's like, it's not that we don't hear what you're saying. It's just that
it's
one
space.
Woman in here and it's 12 dudes in here. You're going to get
you
12 different
off.
Reasons for why you was wrong in that situation.
Man,
and it ain't no way
you're
going to prove us. It ain't no way you can prove us that you was right.
That's true. It's
like 100% right, like without fault. It's always we gonna find a reason. Well, you could have been there. Cause I seen it a couple of weeks ago when this lady came in and she was talking about her divorce because she said that she had proof of infidelity and she was gonna take her husband and the side joint to court and
oh,
sue both of them.
She was the barbershop talking about
like Fantasia. And I was like, damn, she gonna. Crazy, but the way she was talking about it, it was like
she got that shit playing.
Like, it's like you gonna do all this, but it sounds like you still want to be with him though.
Right.
So then, instead of talking about that, we spent the whole time our haircut talking about where she thought everything went wrong at and what she could have did to make it not do that.
What the fuck she could have did? What about what he could have did?
We talked about that too, but
at the same time,
we ain't finna just be like, "Yeah, he was wrong." It's always gonna be a "What did you do?"
Right?
Because
oh,
we do.
Shit, that's that guy coach.
Exactly.
It's
always
the barbershop.
It's the barbershop. It's always gonna be a "What did you do?"
Prioritize. That's like one of us going into the salon talking some shit.
What?
Y'all in there talking about some? Yeah, man, them niggas ain't shit. We going there. Wait, what you mean? We, you know what I'm saying? We ain't gonna be able to get off in there.
I can't get off.
Can't
ain't,
get off
y'all
in
ain't
there.
Even letting it go down like that.
Y'all, no. Mm-mm. At least in the beauty shop, we will play both sides. Like if we feel like she was wrong in a beauty shop, we will tell her she's wrong. Y'all just like. We don't give a damn if the nigga was wrong or not. We still on his side. It's just like some kind of man code.
Nah, we'll even hey
man,
for a lot of the instances
sometimes.
That I heard, even though he was wrong, I still be like, I understand why he did it. Shit. That don't mean he right, but I understand. I'm a dude. I get it. I definitely get it. That don't mean it's right,
child,
though.
Please.
That's how we play both sides.
Right.
Lord, child, right. Please.
We ain't gonna all the way be like, hey, she you right, but you know what I'm saying? Nah. Not in the barbershop.
Whatever.
That shit wild.
Y'all have y'all own little man thing. Whatever.
That's what it's for, though.
We rarely get those spaces. For.
I remember this one time, man. God, I think it was Tony that was with me. We had went to the barbershop. Matter of fact, across the street from A&T, that barbershop
right
there.
That's probably one of the littest ones in the
yeah,
world, too.
I remember it was got there. We had been sitting there about an hour. It was Saturday trying to hurry up and get a haircut. Nigga in there in his cape getting his hair cut and shit. Some nigga walk up in there, Like he walk up in there, see him. Like you can see like some shit. He like looked at him. Then he like he sat down for a bit, was like on his phone and shit, looked at him again, walked out. Got down about 10 minutes later, another nigga walk in there, got down, walked straight up in there, walked to the back. Meek, meek. Just started meeking him in the chair.
Why in the chair, bro.
He's sitting there getting cut up. He's sitting there getting edged up. Just started making him bop, bop, bop. Dude, ooh. Get up, start fighting. Bop, bop. They fighting and shit.
Who broke the shit up?
Look, so the first chair bob, I remember this shit. First chair bob was like, nah, man, you can't do that. You can't come up in here wild like that, man. You can't be doing that shit, bro. So he tried to pull him off of him. And so then when he tried to pull him off of him, goddamn dude was swinging, hit him too. So then he hit him. So then dude by the first chair started fighting him. Dude that walked in the first time come back in and started fighting. The four of them all fighting. Dude, have you been into that barbershop before?
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember. It's the same dude. I think the dude that owned it that's hitting the back.
Mm-hmm.
Pulled out a pistol. Went, he got like a little shit in the back, pulled out a gun. All them niggas started. That shit was crazy. Nigga was in the shit. He was like, all right, I got something for that ass. I got you. I got something for you. Sprint out. So we sitting there like, oh, this nigga about to come back. We got them pistol or some shit.
Did y'all stay or did y'all leave?
Bro, we had to stay.
Yeah! Bro, you gotta lose that spot.
That nigga was not trying to lose that spot.
Look, barbershops take without a
appointment. Y'all on the line to get a damn haircut.
That nigga was not trying to lose that spot.
And this is like 2009, 2010. This is before niggas had apps and shit. Goddamn, bro.
That nigga
sitting
said,
there and
no,
wait.
I don't give a fuck.
Who's like,
look,
bro,
your
I gotta
shot.
Get this haircut, man. I can't.
But that used to be the fun. That used to be the funniest barbershop in Greensboro where stuff used to go down. There. That whole shopping center where Eminem at. Shit used to go down there over all the time.
All the time.
Eminem. I'm surprised ain't nobody got them bought that bitch or sold that bitch.
Right.
Have you been in there?
I tried to
when
stay
the last,
out there,
when
bitch.
The last time you been in there?
Probably not since I went to school there.
I went in that joint 2 weeks ago. They done expanded. Like,
they
Eminem,
got bundles
I'm
and
telling
t-shirts.
You, they got, bro, they got hair, they got t-shirts, they got
everything.
I'm talking about Eminem huge now. Right. They got cameras in the joint. You just
that's
see
crazy.
On TV. I'm like, yo, they done came up. Off,
it's
off.
Crazy because if you stood like in the middle of the street and took a picture of Eminem, you would think you was in the hood.
Yeah. You
but the other side don't look like the goddamn hood.
It don't.
But it that don't. Eminem, that shit like the fucking hood.
All the way until you get to that little restaurant, right?
I'm like, hey, T need to go ahead and buy this bitch. What the fuck they doing, bro? Shit.
If they ain't gonna put no barbershop on campus, they need to buy that little plaza right there.
They
that's what I was saying. I'm like, they must be got to holding that bitch out for some cash.
Ain't no way, but then I don't know if that Indians or Arabs or however you say it, but
them niggas got that shit locked down.
Not their part anyway.
Right.
Hell no, but I'm like, God damn.
Is you gonna put those guys in here? Nah.
They want their money.
What?
I used to hate going up there, but that'd be the only thing open too.
Bro, I'm telling you, Eminem huge now. It's like two of them. Like, that's how it's doubled in size. That's how big it is.
Them niggas real. Because I don't know if I could have did that shit that long, bro.
Bro, they out there putting that shit going they put, on. Remember the car ran through the store?
Oh, yes. Remember that shit.
You don't remember that?
Ran through the Eminem?
Yes, bro. Drunk car went home, come and ran through Eminem.
Yes.
Through the front of that jump.
Whoa.
Damn.
Oh, my gosh. That was
wild,
I forgot all about that.
Yeah, that was crazy. Or every homecoming where the joint over there by the bookstore. Somebody
I remember that
hit,
shit. I remember
somebody
that
used
shit.
To hit that wall every homecoming.
I remember that shit.
That joint used to be
that
sad.
That shit was fucked up for a minute.
That shit was fucked up the whole time we was in
school. Yep.
I get pride out this bitch. Okay.
Homecoming be lit, bro. I'm telling you. That's why they call it G-Ho.
They do. Are y'all going homecoming 2020?
Oh, yeah, nigga.
It's on Halloween.
I know the costume party going to be lit.
Going to be lit.
Y'all know what y'all going to be?
Be a Power Ranger or some shit. Goddamn. I don't want to be a Power everybody. It'd probably be a whole bunch.
Some cosplay anime shit.
Right.
You got hair too. You got to do some cosplay shit.
Probably.
Get it stupid.
I definitely want to do some shit where don't nobody know it's me.
Okay.
Something where you got to wear a mask.
Something like, yup. Y'all just be in there acting a fool.
Just keep that bitch up. Like, go crazy. Like, we definitely got a vlog next homecoming.
Fuck around, go viral. Don't nobody know it's me, goddamn.
Who the fuck this nigga I am?
They gonna know now.
That's a goddamn fool.
You remember that nigga that fell asleep on the concrete last year?
What?
Remember that shit went viral? It was for G-Ho. You posted this shit, nigga. It was a nigga that was asleep on the concrete, like on the steps, knocked out.
Yeah!
Like it was comfortable as hell, goddamn.
That's not alcohol. That's that like liquor, boy.
Like, I know, like that, but like that shit was comfortable as hell, boy.
He was knocked out. He did go viral.
The only other place I done seen people slumped out like that after a weekend was our ECU. That joint was sad, I heard too.
But I have never been to ECU, but I always hear that shit be crazy.
Yeah.
Like, they homecoming, Halloween time in general.
The Halloween joint be wild, bro. I'm talking about.
And we always talked about going out there, bitch.
You know how never we got that, like, the houses around campus or whatever?
Mm-hmm.
Like, they got houses around campus, too. Some of them frat houses or sorority houses. But it literally be like multiple people, like might be like outside the house on the grass, slump, red cups everywhere.
That's crazy. You know, that's one thing. Like when I went to NT, I realized they didn't really have frat houses and shit.
They, like on campus. They did our first year.
They be getting into some shit. Bro.
Right, and then AMT I believe was kind of like nah.
They had frat houses.
You know.
Where at?
It's the houses across the street from. The Aggie 4, you know what I'm talking about?
In that area.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. It's like these houses.
Mm-hmm.
That used to be some of the Greek homes.
Really?
Yep. And then, yeah, they ended that.
You know, you ain't never heard none of the stories, none of the folklore that be happening about why shit be ending. I ain't gonna talk about it out here because I ain't got liberty to talk about that story.
It's a folklore.
What is it? T83 classified? I can't
remember. I heard them fables, goddamn boy. That shit used to go in.
But the rumors you used to hear around campus or why stuff don't happen no more, you'd be like, what?
Yeah.
I believe it, man.
That shit happened.
That shit.
Wait,
people a lot of shit under the rug.
About five, six years. Give about another 14. Some crazy shit gonna come out.
I believe it.
Some crazy shit.
It's too many niggas trying to record everything nowadays, boy. No, back then you can get away with shit. It's your word against the word, you know.
We saying back then like it was that long ago.
It was though, bro.
2014 seemed like a decade ago almost.
Like 2012, like niggas had
like recording cameras shit, and shit, but we weren't recording living shit.
We ain't record and post it. Nah, like, it was more so like let me record it and show my friends or something.
Yeah,
like,
you know
how many times niggas almost got shot. Where was the cameras at then?
Right.
Facts.
Well, never no cameras out.
Right.
Facts.
I don't know why our mindset was so dead because we didn't record to like. I mean, niggas still did it like World Star shit, but it wasn't like
right.
Everything like had to be. You know what I'm saying?
Niggas be living through that damn camera lens now, boy.
Right. Yeah. I'd be scared to go out here, but and just act up.
Videos
be on somebody's Snap story.
Right.
Yeah, Snap was getting popular when we was gonna graduate.
Mm-hmm. Like, Bree, look at this nigga out here dancing with this bitch.
Yeah, we had a party. What goddamn shit.
You know what I'm saying? I'm just dancing. What the fuck?
That's funny.
That's the same situation like they had that girl in the video.
Yeah.
When she was grinding on brush, she was like, get my face out the video.
And that's crazy. You want to know, that's something we learned in camp that always stuck with me. Like when we worked at camp, where they talked about like snapshots,
mm-hmm.
like how you can be in a situation that's totally not what it is, but to someone who see it for 5 seconds, it could be something, something that's taken out of proportion, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's how that stories be. 15 seconds, nigga.
That's all you need.
You need content first.
Right.
You definitely need the wrong 15 seconds,
right,
boy.
She
be done sued you for everything you had. And then some.
Do y'all still get on Snapchat?
Not really.
I don't even got Snapchat on my phone.
Like every now and then just see like, oh, these niggas still be snapping like actively.
Yeah, once I see like the high schoolers and middle schoolers getting on there really heavy, adding me and so I was like, nah, it's just.
I did get a lot of that.
It was like, nah, I won't end it no more.
You probably was the last person I talked to on Snapchat.
Where is that we got together?
I got rid of Snapchat.
Oh, that's how y'all got together?
I got rid of Snapchat
for the third time. That's how we
Snapchat the devil.
You right, bro.
You see what done happened to me?
And don't act like it's a bad thing.
So who snapped who?
Well, he finally unblocked me from all social media.
We're not gonna talk about it.
Let me go through these block lists real quick. Man,
finally unblocked me after so many years later.
We good.
Though. I did unblock everybody though. After a while, it was like,
I got like a notification or something. And then
Boom over here snapping. I be getting that shit too sometimes. This nigga snapping. I'm like, what? This nigga ain't even send me a Snapchat.
And he would be with his son a lot. And I thought his son was so cute. So I would snap him and like send the heart emojis about his son. And then that's how it started. But I was just trying to fuck.
Damn.
Savage life out here.
No, I was a savage.
What? No, it wasn't like that. It was just kind of like an old thing. Try one more time and then go about your business.
That's what they all say. I need closure.
It was not a closure. Trust me, we had already lied
saying I need closure.
Yeah, we had plenty of that.
Closure ain't nothing but a goddamn lie.
Closure was different.
Yeah, like.
But I was like, whatever. I was trying to get my lineup for homecoming, and he was the lucky pick. So I was like,
piece of meat out this month.
Well, let me start early.
That's what you get though, because I ain't been to homecoming in like 3-4 years. So that's what you get.
And then it didn't work like that. He basically looked at me like, you ain't finna treat me like no meat.
You gotta work for it, goddamn. Right. You gotta work for it, goddamn shit. Goddamn. That's what we do in 2020.
And then now
know your worth, King.
Know your worth.
Know your word.
Boy, bye.
Girls out here just like niggas, boy.
Yeah.
Group dates and shit. Birthdays and holidays and shit.
Group dates going to Arigato's. They didn't ask me if I wanted some Arigato's, boy.
You go to Arigato's?
Hell no. I ain't going by myself, boy.
Good nigga said, hell no.
Trying to save money from 2020.
Okay. For real, for real.
Oh, this is probably the only time I eat out for the next couple of days.
Okay.
All that damn food you cook. And I still got some greens and black-eyed peas, too. I'm lit. Go get me a piece of cornbread.
He like my food, though.
Eat my New Year's Eve shit.
I cook enough for him so he don't have to spend money to go out to eat. He can have everything at work.
Superstition? The black-eyed peas on New Year's?
Shit. The pork, the black-eyed peas, the cornbread, the green.
And he wanted it all.
For real. To me, it's good, though. That's a good little meal.
He supposed
right
to have
there.
Fried chicken, black-eyed peas, collard greens, pig.
He made a big scene.
I ain't make no big scene.
I was just messing with you. You the one that blew it all out of proportion.
No, he really wanted the works.
It wasn't the works. The only thing that take all day is black-eyed peas.
No, you got to slow cook them collard greens for it to be good.
Collard greens take a minute.
Yeah, but I mentioned collard greens way before New Year's Eve.
We had collard greens for Thanksgiving, collard greens for Christmas.
And guess what the hell? We didn't have it at.
I was sick of collard greens.
It ain't always.
Whatever. He spoiled. He got what he wanted. I didn't cook them, but I got him a plate.
Shout out to Aunt Tanya for looking out for your boy.
Shoot. What did you eat for New Year's?
What did I eat? Salmon.
That's good.
Some shrimp Alfredo.
That sounds good.
Seafood Italian, boy.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Italian seafood souffle.
Born it in, boy.
So how did you bring in your New Year?
I was here.
I mean, what did you do? Was you sleep? Was you watch your TV? Did you take a shot?
Me and KJ was up.
KJ was up with you?
I kept him up.
You want to be on any other time?
Right.
Stay up.
I gotta be here with you, bro. You gonna stay up, bro?
What come on TV for New Year's nowadays? Y'all was watching TV?
Nah, Netflix and shit. But like Don Lemon. It's like I said, Lemon. Is it Lemon or Lenny? You know what I'm talking about? Don, the light skinned black dude.
That's before our time, anyway. So let's get
him and Steve Harvey be doing like the ball drop and shit.
Oh, they do got the ball drop on TV.
I never knew that.
I ain't never paid that no mind.
Steve Harvey be doing that shit. No, Steve Harvey do everything. Yeah, out there.
Steve Harvey do the damn Miss Universe, Miss World.
Everything.
New Year's.
Think Like a Man.
Family Feud, damn. TV show, radio show. God, I'm like, too God much. Damn, Steve Harvey.
And we be thinking Nick Cannon got all them jobs.
Yeah.
Steve Harvey, stay on TV.
That nigga don't play, boy.
He don't.
He like don't. Stephen A. Smith, but he be on it.
What's the name? I think he got a bevel contract now because he did that little jump with the bevel razor. He was edging up that little fro he got on his lip.
Oh, he did that, Stephen A. Smith?
No, I'm talking about Steve Harvey. Stephen A. Smith just got that big bag from ESPN. I think that jumped like $8 million or something like that.
A year?
Mm. A year?
Yeah.
Oh, my God. I thought the contract was $8 million. $8 million a year.
I think he said he got $8 million a year.
God damn, that mean
he legit getting ball money.
Right.
$8 million. That mean they know he gonna come to work every time they call his ass. Cause they can't just get nobody that.
And Steven Jackson and what's the other nigga?
All the Smoke.
Yeah.
On Showtime.
Podcast, yeah.
Yeah, that shit on Showtime. That should be good. Bro, that shit is crazy.
But he went on there. He was talking about it. He was like, yo, they know I'm reliable. You know what I'm saying? Anytime, you know what I'm saying? Them niggas call. Yeah. Like,
I ain't seen that one yet, but I do be watching that junk, though.
And he had some good points. He was talking about, so you know how he talk about a weed lot.
Yeah.
And then, like, people, like, you know why you gonna always give niggas a hard time smoking weed? He basically clarified the shit. He was like, he ain't got a problem with people smoking weed, but when you let it interfere with your money.
I thought that was a given. That's the thing I don't understand about Stephen A. Like,
he a gimmick.
When it come to that, that's a given. Like every time his stance on certain stuff don't change.
No.
Especially when it come to getting money, it do not change. His stance, I've been watching Stephen A. Smith, and his stance has always been, don't let nothing get in front of your money, especially if you look like me. That's why he be so upset about Josh Gordon getting kicked out of the NFL for weed, which I don't believe is weed because as far as I know about the NFL and how many ways you can get out of drug tests and not get caught and this, that, and the third, ain't nowhere in hell niggas getting caught for no motherfucking weed.
Right. And the white dude, I've been watching a lot of them shits, but the white dude used to punt for the Colts.
Yeah.
He got a podcast. He talk about that shit.
Yeah,
like,
Pat McAfee.
All the time.
He
yeah.
funny as hell, though.
He is.
He funny as hell. He like white people funny. Like.
Yeah.
He funny as fuck, though. It's like the white dude that's cool with everybody.
Yeah.
Like, funny. That motherfucker's crazy. But, yeah, man, like, Stephen A. Smith, he for him to be from Winston-Salem, well, not from Winston-Salem.
He is from Winston. Yeah, he went to Winston-Salem.
Played basketball there and all that, and now to look at where he at now, that's lit, bro.
It is.
That's lit, bro. And I don't even know his whole story, but... He said he's been doing sports for 20-something years. That's a long road to finally get to $8 million.
Right.
That's a long road.
You know, everybody think you just get money like that, though. Like, especially
exactly.
today.
And I honestly thought Stephen A. would have been worth more than $8 million a year from ESPN as long as he's been
right.
holding it down. At the same time, that probably...
Go ahead and say it. If
that
it's probably, bad, I'll
that
take it
probably,
out.
That probably was Stuart Scott money.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, Stuart Scott was a Space Jam, bro. Yeah. Stuart Scott was that man.
Nah, that's how I go, though. Somebody,
Stuart Scott was that man.
Like,
I feel like Stephen A. probably would have got paid still, but Stuart Scott probably, if Stephen A. got $8 million, Stuart Scott would have got some bread, bro.
Oh, definitely. That's how I be, man. Some people, you know what I'm saying, pass away. Somebody got to...
Let me open up the door for somebody else.
Let me get on up in there.
$8 million a year.
Man, what's going on with the bank? Y'all niggas goddamn changing names and shit, bro. I got to go check my goddamn bank account one day. You niggas talking about some Julian. I'm like, what? As long as this shit don't complicate none of this shit, bro. Goddamn.
The ugliest name.
Trulian. I'm like,
everybody will get used to it eventually.
Is it Truliot or Trulian?
It's truest.
What?
Like, I'm true to this shit.
So how you spell? Nah, let's like spell what? That shit. T R U
I S T.
Truest. They wild for that.
Whoever was on their marketing team was definitely some millennials.
Some what?
Millennials.
Definitely.
I don't know how, because true religion ain't really.
I bang with the true.
Yeah, like ain't nobody really talking about truths no more.
Man.
That was 2013, 2 Chainz.
True. True.
As long as I ain't got to change bank accounts and no shit. No, I got to do that shit, change numbers and all that.
If you didn't get a letter by now, then no.
Thank you.
So that means you
I'm like, that. These niggas here.
Where did you open merge. Your institution at? Your
SunTrust.
No, like what location?
Durham. That shit matter? Damn.
No, fuck. It doesn't. If you didn't get a letter about a divestiture, then you're fine. So you'll be good. Cause you might end up banking somewhere else, but you should be fine.
True is goddamn.
So we got Wells Fargo, we got Bank of America, and we got True.
Truest.
Yep.
Those are the 3 major ones. They don't bother everybody else out.
Right. Wells Fargo used to be goddamn something else.
Wells Fargo bought out Wachovia.
Yeah.
I like Wells Fargo better than Wachovia, though. That name was what?
Wells Fargo is the face.
Yeah. Boy, what?
Oh, for real? I believe it.
There's some sharks out there, boy. Mm-hmm. Sharks in the water. That's why they color red. When you come in there, they sniffing for blood, boy. I'm telling you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that is.
Come on over here. Open this goddamn shit right here, boy. Let me tell you. All the benefits.
Shit be free sure. 6 months down the road. It be free. Not right now. But they going to tell you it's free, though.
2 years from now, you motherfucker paying goddamn 600% on a dollar or some stupid shit. They're like, God, where the fuck my money going?
I'm telling you.
Back to Wells Fargo.
Right. Banks the true one. Banks crazy.
As ever.
That's what capitalism is, bro.
You got some bank secrets to tell? Mm-hmm. Some tips?
Tell me how bro from Charlotte got off, please.
What?
Please. How he?
Bro, what?
You know the dude from Charlotte who stole that money from Wells Fargo and was flexing? You remember that?
I do.
How he did that?
Is he still locked up?
Being stupid.
He better be locked up. He's stupid.
He probably would have never got caught.
He bought a new car and everything.
Like they said he was doing it for like 6 months.
He been doing it. Because he's
like long as shit.
Bro, this nigga stole $88,000 to go put a down payment down. Why the fuck would I spend the whole $88,000 that I stole? Why the fuck would I spend that shit on the car for one?
That's dumb, my nigga. That nigga was dumb.
That nigga stole from the safe. From the vault to flex.
Like that wasn't even a dumb part. He could have got away with it.
If
he was flexing that long and didn't get caught, he probably could have got away with it if he was just goddamn silent with the shit.
He eventually would have got caught. They probably just hadn't had an audit yet. Because the auditor comes and sees all of that. They piece count everything.
Once a year?
Mm-hmm.
I was about to say, it's got to be once a year. He was out here. He was out here. My boy started a clothing line, bought a damn label.
Nigga was rapping.
What? All types of shit. Got his teeth fixed. You know you got bread when you get your teeth fixed, nigga.
Nigga pull up and work like, how you get the money for that BMW, dog, that Mercedes, bro?
I'm anxious rapping, to see how nigga. That's going to play out.
What you mean that nigga going to jail?
No. I want to know how he did that.
That nigga going to jail, bro.
I mean, they could say that most of that money came from his clothing line.
Yeah, he could.
Like, if he get a fire lawyer.
He didn't have no clothing line before he was working at Wells Fargo. They probably got his business accounts with his stupid ass.
His ass probably did open business accounts there.
I know for a fact his dumb ass opened a business account. Because this what they said he did. They said that bro would steal money from the vault and go to the ATM and deposit it in his account. So he definitely had more than one account.
He would go deposit somewhere. The same bank he's stealing from. God damn.
Shit, as stupid as it sounds.
God, boy.
They even look at my account. I work here.
That's wild.
Damn, bro.
That shit was crazy. That might be the dumbest thing of the decade. What was dumber than that of the decade?
I don't know, man. Besides, it has been 10 years, bro.
The dumbest thing of the decade besides that, what was?
It's been some dumb shit out there.
Yeah, I can't think.
It's like I can't even think of shit from like 2011. God, it was probably dumb shit from 2011. I can't even think about that whole Jesse shit was dumb as hell.
Oh yeah, that was just as dumb. That was just as dumb. That was
he's
just
still
as dumb.
Claiming his innocence.
They talking about letting that boy back on Empire. They're trying to get them ratings back. Don't nobody watch that shit.
Don't nobody watch that shit.
They
trying to get them ratings up.
I don't know how they canceled Star and kept Empire.
Right. How does that happen?
I know everybody watched Star. I don't know how Star ain't came back after they seen how social media reacted to it.
That's wild.
Everybody was cutting up when they canceled Star.
It's wild. It's been a decade. You got me over here thinking about that shit. Whole 10 years.
And you thinking back on 2009, like, what the fuck was I doing?
I can't remember shit from 2009. I remember shit from 2009, but goddamn. Like, the itsy bitsy pieces.
What?
That shit is impossible. 2010. Niggas at A&T.
2009. Right. That one when Michael Jackson died, ain't it?
Bruh, Michael Jackson died.
In 2009, ain't
it? Our freshman year orientation, that shit was crazy.
Yeah.
So what, 2010?
Was that freshman year orientation? Like eating lunch. First time A&T. That shit come when they had the TVs on. That shit came across the TVs.
Prince died right after.
Like, oh!
Prince died right after, like the next year.
Did he?
2000.
I believe so.
We went to a Prince concert that next year. Prince died in like 2015, maybe? Oh,
okay. See? 16? That's how fast it run together.
That shit crazy.
What up?
That Michael Jackson shit was crazy.
That Michael Jackson shit was wild.
Is the doctor still locked up? They proved it?
I think he locked up shit.
You think he purposely tried to kill Mike?
There was some conspiracy around that.
Just think about how long. That's the long ass 10 years that we went. The beginning of the decade, we was more than Michael Jackson death. The end of the decade, Michael Jackson the monster.
Yeah.
The beginning of the decade.
That shit wild, right?
R. Kelly was that nigga. The end of the decade, he's a monster.
They got a part two coming
they
out.
They got a part that don't need to come out no damn more.
They
got to
put him in dirt.
It's coming out tomorrow, actually.
What?
Yeah.
The beginning of the decade, Chris Brown was an animal. Now he probably everybody the most famous motherfucker on earth.
Yo, the crazy thing about R. Kelly, bro, everybody know that nigga been doing that shit. Ain't nobody give a fuck, bro.
They got Dame Dash.
Cause they was getting paid.
Niggas was getting money.
They was
money.
Getting that bread.
Niggas was getting step in the name of love, buddy. They ain't give a fuck.
Money, imagine how much money they was embezzling from that nigga for them niggas not to give a fuck.
I was like, yo, this nigga married Aaliyah back in 90 something. Niggas was like, "Hey,
imagine how much money you got
this
to
nigga
be
on
stealing.
Space Jam."
Right.
You got to be stealing from a nigga for you not
bro,
to give
you
a
got
fuck.
To,
what he doing morally? Cause ain't no way in hell they was just taking what they was getting paid, bro.
No, like today, that shit wouldn't even fly a day. Goddamn, that nigga came out. Yeah, I married goddamn Malia. She's 16. I'm 30, but it's all right.
Oh,
yeah,
be a
that
big
shit
uproar.
Wouldn't fly today.
Right.
I don't know what the fuck nigga was on in the '90s. Goddamn, bro.
You can't say
it's different, bro.
You can't say in the '90s though, cause. Bro, your grandma probably married a nigga who was 30 something and she was 16.
Probably,
17.
Bro. Ain't no cause
I know my
shit was.
I know my grandma did.
That's how shit was back
my
then.
My grandma was like 20, bro. My granddaddy was 40 something. That shit was crazy. It shit always been like that. It's just different. Motherfuckers evolve, niggas think differently. And some people don't get with that shit.
That shit wild.
Because even like, even R. Kelly back then, it's like, what do you want from Aaliyah besides the fact that she looked good? Because
it won't like. Fully developed back then.
That's what I'm saying. It won't like, God damn, Aaliyah.
Won't like Aaliyah sure. Had fat ass.
That man. Motherfucker, you know, look, Aaliyah, know, look how she was posing, look, a good, kid.
But goddamn, at the same time, that's wild.
She looked like a kid, bro. And he wanted that shit. Like, what the fuck?
Oh, man. What was you saying about Dame Dash?
He's on there on the part two.
Oh, Dame that nigga stepped up in
Dame
that bitch.
Dame Dash was fucking with her, too, before R. Kelly was.
He was. Dame, I think Dame Dash was fucking with her after she was 18. But still.
I thought Dame and Jay was fucking with her.
And, yeah, sound like.
Ooh, what?
He about to drag R. Kelly through the mud.
He about to. Oh, definitely.
Oh, damn.
But, you know, he already talked about it, like, a little bit in interviews. He said, like when Jay-Z and R. Kelly was doing all that before Best of Both Worlds, what's that one song they had?
Was it
Moody
Blueprint?
Booty something?
No, that was just Jay-Z.
Moody Body Like a Snake. No, it was some shit like that.
That was
some shit. It was one of them songs they had, and Dame Dash was like, he won't fucking with that shit. He was like, he didn't show up to the video shoot. He won't fucking with that nigga because he knew.
Because he knew.
R. Kelly was that nigga back then, boy.
That's crazy, right?
That's how I know they was. Bro,
that's
R. Kelly,
crazy,
was,
right?
He was not missing back then. Like, you know how Lil Uzi don't be throwing out no slap. Like, R. Kelly was going crazy back then.
R. Kelly was dropping 12 played and dropping goddamn I Believe I Could Fly. Like
back and forth, goddamn, back and forth the whole time.
Every genre. That nigga was killing, bro.
That shit is crazy. Then he was writing music for other niggas. That's how you know you going crazy. You got 12 songs on the top 100. Four of them you wrote, eight of them yours.
He's very talented. He's just, he got some mental issues and some demons he need to go to therapy for.
Oh, no, it's too late
for that. He was raised.
Be the most talented ones most of the time. I get pushed out in the forefront, the ones who got the most effed up issue.
Too late for that therapy now, goddamn.
Yeah.
You're going to jail.
Hopefully he is rehabilitated if he come out.
Nah.
That
nigga ain't nothing else for him to do in there besides singing.
You wanna know how I know that nigga ain't rehabilitated? That nigga went to court, got free, and still was doing the same shit, goddamn. Boy, that nigga ain't goddamn. That nigga sick, bro. That nigga went to court, bro. Somehow got off with a tape. Had a nigga on tape. What'd he do when he got out of jail? Did the same shit.
He must got some type of brainwashing powers or some shit, bro.
I think he thinks he's going to beat this. And he just...
Not this time, man.
Learned his lesson.
Not this time. Mm-mm. That ain't going to jail.
That shit do run out. That shit run out. But they damn sure got Bill.
Somebody said, yo, you got that fire ass music. I'm going to give you a second chance. And he fucked it up. Went and did the same shit.
Fucked it up how many times, though? He fucked it up a couple times.
Yeah.
I mean, he out here kidnapping bitches. He fucked it up a lot, bro.
Got them doing an interview talking about they ain't kidnapped.
That's what I'm saying.
He was brainwashed.
He is doing some type of waterboarding shit, some type of damn war tactics on their head.
Got them brainwashed.
They got everybody in the outside looking in, talking about come home, this, that, and the third. And they talk about, motherfucker, y'all was beating me at the house. Ain't no food there. Y'all used to make me eat what y'all cook. Regular shit they arguing
about.
Pick
them. Pick the ones that been through it, goddamn. Yeah, my daddy used to beat me and shit. Oh, shit, I ain't gonna beat you. Come on.
You can't come out the room.
You got them locked in shit. You can't come out the house.
Can't come out the room at all. And you got to ask to use a bathroom.
That's wild.
That is wild.
See, you know what's crazy? Like in the 70s, that shit will probably be okay. As far as goddamn, if some nigga had some shit like that, niggas wouldn't even be mad at that. In the 70s and 60s? No.
I mean,
if
shit.
They had,
the type of drugs they was doing back then, they probably would have forgot about that shit the next day anyway.
That's true.
In the 70s, Bills was giving niggas Quaaludes, so you know they ain't give a fuck about what the fuck was going on.
Bills getting off for
Bill
years.
Bill was giving niggas Quaaludes. In the 80s, they was doing crack. They ain't give a fuck about shit. long as that shit didn't affect what they was doing.
I really think we are good. We are better people in 2020. Like,
but that's because we know what happened. Because the shit coming to the light.
Yeah.
At a time where niggas is not willing to accept no type of shit, because niggas ain't taking no shit nowadays.
Mm-mm. niggas barely go to work and no take some nowadays. Goddamn bullshit. Nigga. Okay. Like, what? No.
Facts.
Let alone some shit like that.
Yeah, mom.
A nigga Bill Cosby. You seen a nigga just in jail, goddamn.
Yeah,
boy.
He just sitting there. Just.
What's crazy about it is bro was in there going blind.
Yeah.
I don't know, bro.
They just say he already blind. Like, he done went blind.
Now, he was going blind before he went in that joint. So he probably is blind.
He blind.
Especially with that bullshit they feeding him. That shit probably made it worse. That nigga got
probably
all...
chopping shit up in there, goddamn. Yeah, goddamn.
I just wonder why they waited so late.
I just wonder why, too, because Bill Cosby done left his mark on the world.
Right. They waited till he got in his freaking 80s to want to
put him on blast.
Like, I'm trying to figure out, did they get money out of it? Like,
I think so. I think it was a settlement along with the other shit. He's still going to jail, but I don't know. That shit wild.